Okay, so today we are going to see second type, that is 3-inch parabolic arch with supports at the different level. Okay, so up till now we have studied the type 1 in which 3-inch arch with supports at same level, and today we are going to see 3-inch arch with supports at the different levels. Okay, so this is the typical arch I have shown here with supports at different level. Okay, so this arch is ACB. Okay, so here we should note that supports are at the different level. Here A and B, these are the two end hinge supports, and they are at the different level. So height on both side, that is also different. Here the height is H1 and here it is H2. Okay, and here this highest point, which is crown, that is not at the midway, but it is at a distance L1 from A and L2 from B. Okay, so this point must be noted here. The highest point here, which is nothing but the crown hinge, that is not exactly at the hub, but it is at distance L1 from A and distance L2 from B. So this is our 3-hinge arch with supports at different level. So here this distance is L1. Distance of crown hinge from point A, L1, distance of crown hinge from point B, that is L2. Height here is H1 on this side, and on this side height is H2. And total length L1 plus L2, that is equal to L. Okay. So if only H1, H2 and L total length is given, then how to calculate L1 and L2 separately? Okay. So for that, we have to use following formula. L1 is equal to L root H1 divided by root H1 plus root H2. That is our formula to calculate L1. When we are knowing total L, H1 and H2. So L root H1 divided by root H1 plus root H2. That is L1. How to calculate L2? L2 is equal to L root H2 divided by root H1 plus root H2. That is our formula to calculate L2. That is nothing but distance of the central crown hinge from point B. Okay. So this is how we can get L1 and L2 if we are knowing H1, H2 and total L. Okay. So again, what is the difference? One difference I have already told, okay, crown hinge, that is not at the midway, but it is at a distance L1 from A and L2 from B. Now let us see what is the second difference. Okay. So second difference, here the equation of the parabola for both the sides, that is different. Means in type 1 we have seen the parabolic arch which is supported at the same level, and equation of parabola throughout, that is same. But here for left portion equation is different, for right portion equation is different. Let us derive these equations. Okay, for left portion to derive the equation, what we have to do, we have to continue this curve AC up to the same curve, we have to continue up to the level of A. Okay, so I have shown such curve. So here I have extended this AC portion as it is up to the level of A. So this is my new curve. Okay, so now we can see this is similar to our type 1 curve where the 3-inch arch is there and it is supported at the same level. Okay, but only difference is here that total span of this particular arch, now it is equal to 2L1. And height of this particular arch, that is nothing but height of the central hinge, which is exactly at the midway for this particular arch. So height of this central hinge, that is equal to H1. So now we can apply this parabolic arch equation with support at the same level. So y is equal to 4h upon l square xl minus x. That is our original equation. This now changes to here now h equal to H1 and l equal to twice L1. So after putting these values, y is equal to 4h1 divided by twice L1 square, x into twice L1 minus x. So this is our new equation. So this is 4h1 divided by 4L1 square, x twice L1 minus x. So the equation after simplifying, it becomes h1 upon L1 square, x twice L1 minus x. Okay. So equation of this portion AC. This CB portion, that is the imaginary portion, that is not present. So for portion AC, we have got now equation as y is equal to H1 divided by L1 square, x into twice L1 minus x. That is our equation for portion AC. Okay. Similarly for a portion BC. Okay. So similarly for portion BC, if we want an equation of this curve, we have to extend the same curve BC as it is up to the level of B. Okay. As we done in our first case for AC. Okay. So this curve is now similar to the our type 1 parabolic arch, where it is supported at the same level. And equation we already know. So y is equal to 4h by l square x into l minus x. That is the equation of the parabolic arch. Here this portion is imaginary, only this portion is present. Okay. And the equation now it is applicable because we have extended now this portion up to the level of B. So this equation, parabolic arch, this is now applicable to this particular arch. But only the difference is that here h is equal to h2 and total l is equal to l2 plus l2. Okay. So here the equation now changes to y is equal to, by putting h equal to h2 and l equal to twice l2, 4h2 divided by twice l2 square into x twice l2 minus x. So after simplifying, we are getting here y is equal to h2 upon l2 square x into twice l2 minus x. Okay. So these are the equations of this arch which is supported at different levels. So there are two different equations. Okay. First difference I have told you, okay, crown hinge is not at the midway, not at the halfway, but that is at a distance L1 from A, L2 from B. Again, the equations for both the curves, they are different, means for portion AC, different equation is there. For portion BC, different equation is there. For AC, equation is y is equal to h1 upon l1 square, x twice l1 minus x. For portion BC, the equation is y equal to h2 upon l2 square, x twice l2 minus x. Okay, so these are our two equations. And one more difference is also there while calculating the reactions. Okay, so when the supports were at the same level, we were calculating the reactions by taking first summation MA equal to 0, after that summation FY 0, and after that to get horizontal thrust, we were using summation MC equal to 0. Okay, so here what you have to do, first equation our remains same, means we have to take moment at A equal to 0. So with that, we are not getting here VB because the supports are at the different level. So we are getting one equation in terms of HB and VB. Okay. So by taking moment at A, we are getting one equation in terms of HB and VB. After that, what we have to do? We have to apply for the whole arch name. So we are getting one equation in terms of HB and VB. After that, we have to split this arch and we have to take moment at C. Okay, so by that we will get one more equation in terms of HB and VB. Okay, so two equations, two simultaneous equations in terms of HB and VB. By solving those, we can get the values of HB and VB. Okay, so now we have got HB. As we have got HB, value of HA also will be same because no horizontal loading on this arch. So horizontal thrust at B and A both are same. Okay, and only remaining is VA. For that, we have to apply summation FY equal to 0. Okay, I'll repeat once again. First of all, we have to apply here when the supports are at the different level, summation MA equal to 0. That will give us one equation in terms of HB and VB. Okay, after that, by splitting the arch, summation MC equal to 0, moment at C equal to 0, we will get one more equation in terms of HB and VB. Solve both, we will get values of HB, VB. And since we have got now HB, this is same, HA will be same as our HB. Okay. To get VA, summation FY equal to 0. So this is the process how we have to get the reactions. So now let us see the problems. Okay. A 3-inch parabolic arch ACB of the span 30 meter has its supports at the depths 4 meter and 16 meter below the crown hinge C. Okay. Means supports are at different level. Means this is the parabolic arch with supports at different level. So this is 30 meter span arch and it is having supports at 4 meter, one support is 4 meter below and other support is 16 meter below the crown hinge. Okay, so this is our crown hinge point and one support 4 meter below, another support is 16 meter below the crown hinge. Okay, the arch carries a point load of 60 kilonewton. So here the point load of 60 kilonewton is there at a distance of 5 meter from the crown hinge. Okay, so this is our crown hinge C, and 60 kilonewton load, that is 5 meter from C, and a point load of 120 kilonewton at a distance of 10 meter from C. So point load of 120 kilonewton is also there, and that is at a distance of 10 meter from C. So two point loads, one at 5 meter from C, and another point load 10 meter from C. So find out the reactions at the supports and bending moment under the load. Okay. So here figure is already given. Okay. So two point loads are there and the supports are at the different level. Okay. So here first we need to calculate L1 and L2. Okay. How to calculate L1 and L2? I have given the formula. L1 is equal to, we are knowing L. Total L we are knowing, and also we are knowing H1 as 4 meter, H2 at 16 meter. So L1 is equal to L root H1 divided by root H1 plus root H2. We will get value of L1. What is the value of L2? L2 is equal to L root H2 divided by root H1 plus root H2. Okay, we will get here L2. So now we are knowing all the dimensions of this particular parabolic arch. Okay, so we have got now L1 and L2. So what we have to find out? We have to find out reactions at the supports and bending moment under the point load. Okay, bending moment at the section which is overlapping with the point load. So here to calculate the reactions, as I told, what we have to do? Take moment at A. Okay, so when we are taking moment about any point, we have to use the sign convention like anticlockwise, positive, and clockwise negative. Okay, so what is the equation? Summation m equal to 0, vb into anticlockwise, vb into 30 minus 60 into thigh minus 120 into please note here, after taking the dimensions here, L1 equal to 10 meter and L2 equal to 20 meter. So L1 here is 10 meter, no need to calculate L2 by formula. You can calculate L2 by formula or total L minus L1, you will get here L2. So L1 is 10 meter here and L2 is 20 meter, okay? And the point load location is given. From crown it is 5 meter, so total is 10 meter, so remaining is 5 meter. From the crown hinge it is 10 meter, so total is 20, means remaining here also is 20, okay? So taking moment at A, what we get? Vb into 30 minus 60 into 5 minus 120 into 20, and moment of this force also, okay? So H, because HB is not passing through now A, so moment of this force, how is the moment? That is also clockwise. So minus HB into this, total is 12 and this is 4, means this distance total is 16, okay? So this 4 means up to this level, this height is 4 and this is 12. So HB into 12, this is again clockwise, means minus. So minus HB into 12, that is equal to 0. After that we are getting one equation in terms of VB and HB. Okay. So to get another equation in terms of VB and HB, what we have to do? We have to split this particular arch at crown hinge C. We have to split this particular arch at the crown hinge C and take moment at C. Okay. So for moment at a point, again anticlockwise, clockwise, sign convention. Okay, so VB, moment of VB is anticlockwise, VB into 20. These two forces moment is clockwise. So minus 120 into 10 minus HB into, what is this distance? Distance of this point C from HB, that is equal to total 16. Okay, so HB minus HB into 16 minus 120 into 10 plus VB into 20, that is equal to 0. After simplifying, we are getting this equation as 20 VB minus 16 HB equal to 1200. So these are two equations in terms of VB and HB. Solve both, you will get values of VB and HB. Okay, so as we have got here HB, HA also will be same because there is no horizontal load on the arch. So HA also same. So only remaining is, we have got now VB, HB, HA. Only remaining is VA. So how to get our next equilibrium equation for the whole arch? Summation FY0. Okay. So VA plus VB minus this 2 point load minus 60 minus 120 equal to 0. We are getting here VA equal to 60 kN. Okay. Now, what we have to do? We have to calculate moment at these two points, okay? So to calculate moment under this point load and under this point load, so consider in the section which is passing through section which is at the level of 60 kilonewton point load. Okay, so what is the moment here? Va into what is the moment? Just use the equation as we do in case of beams. Okay, so Va into phi u minus h into y. So how to calculate this y? By using this curve equation, left side curve equation. What is that curve equation? Parabolic equation, that is equal to y is equal to h1 upon l1 square x twice l1 minus x. That is our equation. And here we have to consider a as our origin and mark x from here. So x is 5 meter. Accordingly, find out what is the y here. Okay. So here I have shown this section. This is my HA, this is my VA, this is the section which is at the level of the point load. And I have to calculate y here to calculate the moment. Okay, so at x equal to 5 meter, what is our equation? Y is equal to h1 upon l1 square x twice l1 minus x. That is my equation. So l1 and h1, they are common. Height of this part, that is equal to 4 meter. And what is l1? L1 we have got as 10 meter. Okay. So x into twice x is now 5 meter twice l1 minus x, 2 into 10 minus x, we will get y. Okay, so our equation for bending moment, Va into phi u minus 75 into y. So we are getting the moment here at 75 kilonewton meter. Okay, to get the bending moment under 120 kilonewton load. So what we have to do here? So we have to consider now right part. Okay, right side of the section we have to consider now. And here again the same process, what we have to do here, here the moment equation, as we know, that is equal to Vb into 10, sagging hogging concept for moment at a section, okay? So Vb into 10 minus Hb into y, that is the moment, okay? So to get y, for this part, the equation for this part we have to use, okay? So y is equal to h2 upon l2 square x into twice l2 minus x. So x, as we know, with b as our origin, section is at a distance of 10 meter, okay? So y is equal to h2 upon l2 square x into twice l2 minus x. So h2 into, we are already knowing, h2 is, what is that? 16 meter, I think. And what is that l2? L2 is 20 meter, right? So x, what we have to put here? X equal to 10 meter. We'll get here y. So after getting y, what is our equation? Vb into 10 minus hb into y. That is our equation. Just put the values and we will get the moment at that section. Okay. Coming towards the next problem. So I think it is clear to you how to calculate the reaction for that summation MA0, MC0, summation FY0. Okay. After that, to take moment, that is the regular process, only calculate Y by using the corresponding parabolic arch equation. Left side equation is different and right side equation is different. Okay. Next is a 3-hinge parabolic arch having supports at different level as shown in the figure carries uniformly distributed load of 20 kN per meter over the left portion of the crown. Okay, so this is the parabolic arch having support at different level. So, as shown in the figure, so depths are given. H1 is given as 5 meter and H2 is given as 3 meter. Means this support 3 meter below crown hinge and this support 5 meter below the crown hinge. And left part is loaded with UDL of 20 kN per meter. Okay. Determine the horizontal thrust developed. Find also bending moment, normal thrust, radial shear at a section 15 meter from the left support. Okay. So we have to calculate E and F and bending moment at a section 15 meter from the left support. And normal thrust, horizontal thrust, we have to calculate. Okay. Means we have to calculate the reaction. So before all these, if we are knowing H1, H2 and L, we must find out the position of this crown hinge, means what is L1 and what is L2. That should be found out first, okay? So for that, our equations are there. L1 is equal to L root H1 divided by root H1 plus root H2. We'll get L1. Just minus it from total L, you will get L2, okay? So this is now parabolic arch with different level supports with all the dimensions, okay? Now what we have to do to calculate the reactions, as we did in our first problem, we have to take moment at A. So that will give us one equation in terms of VB and HB. Okay, so what is that equation? VB into 40 minus HB into VB into 40, that is anticlockwise. HB, that moment is also anticlockwise, so plus. So VB into 40 plus HB into 2. And what is the moment of this UDL? Minus 20 into 22.54 square divided by 2. Okay. Is equal to 0. So VB into 40 plus HB into 2, both anticlockwise, minus 20 into 22.54 square divided by 2, that is equal to 0. So this is my first equation in terms of VB and HB. What to do next? Okay, so here now we have to split this arch at crown hinge C, and again at C we have to apply equation summation MC equal to 0. So I will now consider right part because this is convenient for calculation. Okay. So summation MC equal to 0, VB into 17.46 minus HB into 3, VB into, so what is that equation summation MC, VB into 17.46 minus HB into 3, that is equal to 0. So this is my second equation. Solve both equation, we will get value of both VB, HB, and at the same time we are getting H also, because that is same as HB. So only remaining is what? VA. So for that we have to apply one more equilibrium equation, summation FY0 VA plus VB minus total UDL 20, which is acting over 22.54 meter. So VA plus VB minus 20 into 22.54 equal to 0. So here we get VA. Okay. So now we have asked to find out normal thrust, radial shear and moment at a section which is at a distance of 15 meter from the left support. Okay. So where does it lie? In the left part or right part? Yes, that is lying in the left part, because left part, which is the L1 part, L1 is our 22.54. So 15 meter is less than L1. So that is lying in the left part. Okay. So regular process as we did in case of our three hinge arches with supports at the same level. Okay. So here I need to show here the reaction CHA, VA, and I can find out here V and H by using. Here I have to show, since this part is in equilibrium, there must be some vertical and horizontal force to balance this. So I have shown V and H like this, and this is the UDL which is acting over this part, 15 meter part. Okay, so I am considering LHS of this section, and this side parabola equation is H1 upon L1 square x twice L1 minus x. That is the equation of this parabola on left side. Okay, so to calculate V and H, what we have to do? We have to apply summation fx0 and fy0. So, summation fx fy0, we will get value of V. Summation fx0, we will get value of H. We want values of V and H to be downward only, whether it is plus or minus. Okay. So even if we get the answer of V, suppose at minus, don't correct that direction. Keep it as it is with the minus magnitude and down sign. Okay. After that, normal thrust and radial shear, we are knowing the equation. So theta, which is the angle made by tangent at this section with the horizontal, or angle made by normal direction, normal thrust direction with the horizontal. For that, what we have to use? For that, we have to use that equation of that parabolic arch. Okay. So here we are knowing the equation of this part, H1 upon L, Y is equal to H1 by L1 square X into twice L1 minus X. Okay. So this is the equation, and tan theta is equal to dy by dx. So after derivation, what it changes to? X H1 upon L1 square into, here we have multiplied this x inside, so twice L1 x minus x square. After that, we are taking the derivative. Tan theta is equal to dy by dx is equal to H1 upon L1 square into bracket twice L1 minus derivative of this bracket minus 2x. Okay. So I have to put here x with origin as A. So x is 15 meter, H1 L1 constant, 5 meter and L1, that is equal to 22.54. Okay. So after putting all these values, we are getting value of theta. Okay, so after getting V, H and theta, we can calculate normal thrust and radial shear. So V sin theta plus H cos theta, that is the formula for normal thrust. And for radial shear, V cos theta minus H sin theta. Okay, so for bending moment, we need to calculate Y at this section. Okay, to calculate Y, what we have to do? To calculate Y, again, we have to use equation of this parabola. On this side, okay. So the equation is y is equal to h1 by l1 square, x twice l1 minus x. Just put the values of h l1, h1 l1, and x equal to 15 meter with a as the origin. We'll get value of y at this section, okay. So after putting, we have got value of y as 4.44 meter. And what is the bending moment at this section? Write that equation simply. So va into 15 minus h into y minus 20 into 15 square by 2. Okay, so VA so this is our equation minus h y minus 20 into 15 square by 2. So this is nothing but minus 10 into 15 and VA into 15. Okay, so VA I think that our in our case 352.42. Okay, so we have got here moment also. So this is coming out to be 494 kilonewton meter. Okay, now coming towards the next problem. For a 3-hinge parabolic arch shown in figure, determine location of the central hinge which occurs at the highest point. Find the support reaction. Determine the forces. For the 3-inch parabolic arch shown, determine location of the central hinge. Means we have to find out what is L1 and what is L2 from A and B respectively, where that central hinge occurs. Okay, means we have to find out L1 and L2. Next, find the support reactions. Okay, so we know the process summation EMA0, MC0, FY0. Determine the forces on the section 4 meter from the left support. Also find the location of the section where bending moment is maximum between A and C and its value. Okay. So, location of the central hinge first, okay? So, we have to calculate L1 and L2. We know the formula L1 is equal to L root H1. Here, what is given? H1 is 4 meter, H2 is given at 6 meter, and 40 meter span of dash total L is given, okay? So, we have to find out here what location of the central hinge L1 and L2. So, L1 is equal to L root H1 divided by root H1 plus root H2. We'll get here L1. L2, we can get by formula or by L minus L1, we can get this L2, okay? So we have got both. So location of the central hinge is now found out, okay? So now, reactions, okay? To find out the reaction, summation EMA equal to 0, we'll get one equation in terms of VB and HB. Summation EMA equal to 0, equation in terms of VB and HB. To generate one more equation, what we have to do? Split the arch and consider either left or right part. So I have considered here right part because that is convenient for calculations. Again, generate one more equation in terms of VB and HB. So for taking moment at any point, anticlockwise, clockwise. Anticlockwise positive, clockwise negative. Okay, one more equation. So solve both. We have got now VB, HB. And after that, so as we got now HB, so also we know HA. Get VA only, that is only remaining now. So apply summation FY equal to 0, we will get here VA. Okay. After that, to get normal thrust and radial shear at 4 meter from the left support. So here we need to consider where actually that section lies, whether it is in the left part or right part. Okay. So L1, we have got here as, I think, 18 meter. Okay. L1 we have got here as 18 meters, so 4 meter from the left part means our section is in the left part only. Okay, so here we have to draw the FBD of LHS of the section, okay, because section is in the left part. So with A as origin, we have to mark this, we have to consider now A as origin. Okay, so to get normal shear, we have to first calculate V, H and theta, and after that we need to apply that formula. So consider equilibrium of this portion. This is our vertical force V, this is horizontal force H, and this is the angle theta which is made by tangent at this particular section with the horizontal. Okay, so apply summation fx0, we will get value of h. Apply summation fy0, we will get value of v. So for the whole portion, means we have to consider this UDL in summation fy equation also. Okay, so again, to get theta and y, y will be required to calculate the moment and theta for calculation of the normal thrust and radial shear. Okay, so we will get first y is equal to h1 by l1 square x twice l1 minus x. This is the left side parabola equation. So h1 l1 we are already knowing, and x, what is the distance of this particular section from the left hand hinge? That is equal to 4 meter. Okay, so just put the value of x as 4 meter. H1 l1 we already know. Put the values, we get y equal to 1.58 meter. Again, to get theta, differentiate the equation of the parabola. Tan theta is equal to dy by dx is equal to d dx of h1 by l1 square twice l1 x minus x square. So that is h1 by l1 square twice l1 minus twice x. We will get here theta. Just put the values, we will get normal thrust and radial shear. Okay, and moment at this section. Also, so what is asked to find out? Normal thrust radial shear and maximum bending moment between A and C and its value. Okay, so they have not asked the value of the bending moment at 4 meter, at a section at 4 meter. It is asked to find out bending moment, value of the maximum bending moment between A and C. Okay, so here it should be noted that the maximum bending moment that will occur, one must know that maximum bending moment that will occur in portion AC only. Okay, because that is loaded with UDL, and since in portion BC there is no load, so there will be negative bending moment. Okay, so maximum positive bending moment that will occur in portion AC somewhere at a distance x from A. Okay, and suppose here instead of UDL, here happens to be one point load, then under that point load, that maximum bending moment will be there. Okay, so for now, for this case, UDL is there. So maximum bending moment will occur in portion AC at a distance x from A. Okay, so let us see what is the equation at a distance x. What is that equation? VA into x minus 50 into x square by 2 minus HA into y. Okay, so that is our equation. So here the equation is, at a distance x, the equation is VA into x minus 50 into x square by 2 minus HA into y at a distance x. So this is our equation. And what is the y at a distance x? So that we can get by equation of the parabola on the left side. 1 by L1 square x into twice L1 minus x. This is the equation. So whatever values you know here, that can be put here to simplify it to some extent. So H1 we are knowing, L1 we are knowing, x we are not knowing. That is to be find out here. Okay, so just put the values of H1, L1. Put x as it is. So y1 in terms of x, it will be like this. So moment equation is like this. And as I told in my previous lecture also, to find out location of the maximum bending moment, we have to equate derivative of maximum bending bending moment to the zero. Because maximum or minimum of any function exists where derivative of that function is zero. Okay, so dmx by dx equal to zero. So d dx of this moment equation in terms of x, that is equal to zero. So here we get x as 9 meter. So bending moment will be maximum at 9 meter from the support A. So m max equation we already know, vx into 50 minus h into y. So just put y, this y, in this y x equal to 9 meter. Okay, so we'll get, or in the simplified equation also we can directly put. See, so this is our simplified equation. Okay, so here also you can put that 9 meter, and we can get the maximum bending moment at a section. Okay. Now coming towards our last example, a 3-hinge parabolic arch is loaded and supported as shown in the figure. Determine the support reaction, maximum positive and negative bending moment. Okay. So for support reaction, as we did earlier, the same process we have to apply. Means first we have to find out here L1 and L2. Okay. So for L1 and L2, use our formula L root H1 divided by root H1 plus H2. L2, same formula, L root H2 divided by root H1 plus H2, or we can get it from total L minus L1. Okay. So we have got now L1 and L2. Okay. For reaction, summation MA0, summation MC0, and then summation FY. We will get all the reactions. And after that, what is asked to find out? Maximum positive and negative bending moment. Okay. So now we have got L1, L2 and all the reactions. So everything we are knowing. Okay. So maximum positive bending moment, as I discussed earlier, that will occur under the point load only. And if there happens to be UDL here, then in that range that will happen. Okay. So here we are knowing there is only one point load, and that is in portion AC. So maximum bending moment will be at the position of the point load of 100 kN. Okay. And what is that bending moment? MA into 10, VA into 10 minus HA into Y. To get Y here, use equation of the parabola on this side. So H1 by L1 square, X twice L1 minus X. That is the equation. Just put X equal to 10 meter. You will get value of Y at a distance of 10 meter. So the same process I have followed here. Under the point load, Y is equal to, and X equal to 10 meter I have put here. So Y at that place will be 7.7 meter. Okay. So bending moment VA into 10 minus HA into Y. So that is the maximum positive bending moment. Maximum negative bending moment. Maximum negative bending moment will occur somewhere in the portion BC, because there is no load in this portion. So negative bending moment will occur in portion BC. And let us assume that is occurring at a distance X from point B. Okay. So bending moment at this section will be given by VB into X minus HB into Y. And Y we can write here in terms of X by using equation of the parabola on this side. So here maximum negative bending moment that will occur somewhere in CB. And let it be at a distance of X from B. So Y at X from left parabola equation, H2 upon L2 square X twice L2 minus X. So H2 L2, we are knowing. So put all those values. Okay, we will get one equation in terms of X. And what is the moment equation? That is equal to VBX minus HB into Y. Y is in terms of X. Value is not known exactly. Okay. So MX in equation in terms of X. Okay. So to find out location of the maximum negative bending moment, again, same process, derivative of bending moment equate to zero. So dmx by dx, that is equal to zero. Here we will get value of X, 7.285. So maximum negative bending moment, that is equal to VB into X minus HB into Y. So Y, we know in terms of X, and just put the value of X here. So what is that value? 7.285. Okay. We'll get the value of maximum bending moment, minus 53.25.